Cow-calf operators recognize the value of a regular deworming program to avoid the damage internal parasites can cause in their herds. However, Cattleman to Cattleman reporter Brad Bola tells us not all may appreciate the benefits of dung beetles to their overall pasture management and sustainability efforts.
What do dung beetles have to do with deworming cattle? Monty Tucker, owner of the Tucker Cattle Company in Sweetwater, Oklahoma, knows the importance of both a consistent deworming program and a healthy dung beetle population for the benefit of his cattle and his land.
I'm fourth generation here in Sweetwater, Oklahoma. My great-granddad settled here in 1917. We're mostly commercial cow-calf, heavily Angus influenced. We retain ownership all the way to the rail on every calf on the farm. Soil health is becoming a bigger issue. My great-granddad probably knew about it, and we probably lost focus on it, but now we're focusing back on it and how healthy soil is healthy grass, which is healthy cattle. And a dung beetle is a natural part of that process.
Dung beetles are one of the most important ecological services in a cattleman's pasture system. The number one function is that they're consuming some of that manure. Those cattle are not going to graze around that area as efficiently as they would if that dung was consumed. It's going to not only consume that manure pat, it's going to take those nutrients from that manure pat down into the soil profile, where it allows that both the nutrients and water to get down into the soil profile that allows your grass to grow better.
As a livestock entomologist, along with helping them preserve the viability of their soil, it's part of Dr. Talley's job to help livestock producers realize the most potential from every head in their herd.
Parasites are a major issue for cattle production, and when we think about parasites, it's one of those that can really hit your pocketbook very, very hard. We know through studies that if you were to not apply any parasiticides, then your break-even point on a per-head basis could increase by $20. That's just a break-even point. That's not taking into the losses that can occur when you have large infestations of parasites.
Additionally, an Iowa State University study showed that if producers eliminated dewormers from the beef cattle supply chain, it would cost the industry almost $190 per head produced.
Keeping a good control on parasites, when you retain ownership like I do, we see it into the next system and the next system. If they're parasitic when they go on wheat pasture, they don't perform, they don't come off wheat as heavy. When they don't perform, they don't grade. When they don't grade, it's a lower quality cut of meat and I don't get paid as much.
Keeping a good balance between managing parasites in cattle and maintaining a healthy dung beetle population becomes an important consideration for producers when selecting a deworming product.
We have all kinds of antiparasiticides that are excreted through the manure, but you just need to make sure they're compatible with dung beetle population. If you think about a product like Xydectin, we know that you have a dewormer that is effective on both internal parasites and external parasites. And the research has shown over and over that you can use a product like Xydectin and still maintain an active dung beetle population.
As a practicing veterinarian, I've used both the injectable and pour-on Xydectin products for years. The injectable product has the advantage of when you inject that, you give the exact dose that animal needs. To me, the benefit of Xydectin pour-on is it's waterproof, it has a purple dye so you can tell which ones you did, it has a zero slaughter withdrawal, it lasts 28 days against ostertagia.
Visit with my veterinarian a lot who consults with a lot of entomologists, and we do a rotational deworming program. One I've landed on that I really like is Xydectin. And Xydectin's important to me because soil health is becoming a bigger issue. A product that's dung beetle friendly is important because I don't want to kill them. I like to see them. It's just a healthy ecosystem.
Along with the right product, the right animal, and the right time are critical elements in a successful parasite control program.
The most parasitized animal on the cow-calf farm or ranch is that newly weaned calf. They're always parasitized, so they're always going to benefit. Most people don't know this, but bulls are more susceptible to parasites than cows, than females. So yearling bulls coming out of pasture, they have to be. That's an absolute. And in fact, I would deworm those bulls again in the spring when I turn them out. From a company standpoint, from Elanco, we want you to be satisfied with the products that you buy. These products work very well. We need you to sit down with your herd health veterinarian and get the timing right, get the right product into the right animals, because that's the critical step.
Dr. Talley and Monty Tucker agree on the importance of pasture management and the role it plays in cattle production and the long-term sustainability of an operation.
When you think about pasture management, it's all about how you are utilizing the resources you have and not overutilizing them.
I love being asked the question of sustainability. I'm proud to say I'm fourth generation. My family's been here 110 years. To me, that definition is sustainable. But we have to work hard to keep it sustainable. And I talk about it all the time. We gotta have healthy soil. We gotta have a healthy ecosystem that includes all little critters. And that just turns into a healthy pasture situation that turns into healthy, vibrant cattle.
Reporting from Oklahoma, I'm Brad Bulla for NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen.
To learn more about Cydectin, as well as the benefits of dung beetles, talk with your veterinarian, extension agent, or go to elancolivestock.com.